started gamelan at the University of Michigan as an undergraduate. I was a flutist and I wanted to play with ensembles. And I found the gamelan and it was just this wonderful group of people and it introduced me to an area of the world that I had always been interested in.
I'm Susan Walton and I direct the University of Michigan gamelan, which is an ensemble from Java, Indonesia.
A gamelan ensemble is a set of instruments. It's not like the orchestra in the sense that the orchestra includes the people too. A gamelan is only the instruments, mostly made of bronze, xylophones, or gongs with a few drums. It can be very small, as few as 5 instruments, or the gamelan can have up to 75 instruments.
The gamelan ensemble at the University of Michigan in many ways defines what we do in the field of ethnomusicology and in the area of Southeast Asian studies. It is that defining ensemble that provides identity to a culture, a society that has been in existence for thousands of years.
Universities and colleges have discovered that it is such a magnificent teaching tool. It will accommodate a whole range of musical ability and musical experience.
We have students who have no musical training and they can play the simpler instruments. We have students who have years of musical training and they play the more difficult instruments.
The university is a global institution and so we should reflect a global diversity. And in this regard, the gamelan provides that sense of what life and culture is like in Southeast Asia.
We have wonderful Javanese resident artists who come for either a few weeks or a full semester or a full year or sometimes several years.
Our gamelan comes from Central Java. Bill Malm, who was here as an ethnomusicologist in the 60s, decided to buy one. And so he negotiated to have one brought here. And he taught it for one semester, decided it was too much trouble, and turned it over to me as a fresh graduate student who knew nothing. And I had a very steep learning curve trying to figure out what to do with this wonderful ensemble that we suddenly had.
When you think of Western classical music and you think of the music of Claude Debussy or Maurice Ravel, the French composers of impressionistic music, they were very much inspired by the gamelan. It's my understanding that the gamelan from Indonesia was a part of a worldwide exhibition in France, and that's the first time that Debussy heard it. And knowing what the gamelan sound is like, the kind of sound that it produces, you can actually hear that in Debussy's music.
The modern music is also a big influence for because so many tourists that come to Bali. And then they brought some Western music. We both can inspire each other, you know, like when they're just making around with the gamelan, and oh, that's nice. And also the opposite, you know, I'm playing something and they want to follow it, how you play on the gamelan.
I encourage students to join with their friends because on a big campus like this, I think that it's really important for people to have a group. That was my group when I was an undergraduate, the gamelan. And so I encourage, I say, you know, bring your friends and you'll have more fun. And I think that's an important part of it. And one reason is that the gamelan is a communal event.
For me, there's a different resonance factor because when the large gong hits, I mean, it sort of sends a message out to all of the players. And that gong plays, I mean, for me, the same role that bass drum does in the marching band.
So many students have fallen in love with gamelan and gone to Indonesia after meeting with our Javanese resident artists and studied gamelan music or dance or shadow puppet theater or batik or language.
For anyone who is curious about non-Western sounds, about new sounds, about different sounds. That almost is all it takes. All they have to do is listen, because it's a marvelous sound.